So till now, what we have covered is the meaning of capital budgeting, which is the investment decision of the firm to invest in long-term assets which have a direct impact on the earning capacity and the competitiveness of the firm. Now, capital budgeting decisions become tricky for the firm because they involve forecasts for the future, which might not turn out to be 100% of what is predicted. Okay. Now, capital budgeting decisions are also very crucial because your competitive advantage in the market vis-a-vis your competitors is actually decided by the capital budgeting decisions, because purchase of a new machine, entering a new market, or launching a new product, all these decisions can be make-break decision for the firm. Once these decisions are taken, there is a huge outlay of funds involved. They involve huge funds and they are irreversible decisions. You cannot reverse them back. So because of all these factors, these decisions become very crucial. And they are actually difficult to take because you are making a forecast for the future. So purchasing a machine today, it will have a life of say 3 or 4 years, and you have to decide whether it is worthwhile to purchase the machine or not. Or as we have seen, we have covered replacement questions. So there is a machine in operating situation and you are planning on replacing that machine. Is it worthwhile? Is the new investment worthwhile for your business? Such kind of decisions are made under the capital budgeting domain of financial management. Now, there are a number of techniques which we are using for capital budgeting. To recap, there are two types of broad techniques. One are the traditional techniques, and the other are the modern or discounted cash flow techniques. Discounted cash flow techniques. Now, under traditional, we have done the payback period. And second was accounting rate of return, or the average rate of return. Under the modern techniques, traditional techniques, as the name suggests, they are not very widely used, but they are more consistent with the profit maximization objective, in the sense that they are not covering the aspect of time value of money. Okay. Especially if under this I talk about the accounting rate of return is based on the accounting profits of the firm, while the payback period, though based on cash flows, is still not covering the time value of money, it's still not considering the time value of money. So we move to the modern techniques. In practical real life also, we cover these techniques. Under this, the most important technique is NPV, which is the net present value, IRR, the internal rate of return. Then with NPV, we study PI, which is the profitability index. Then you have the discounted payback period, which is an improvisation over the normal payback period. Then we did MIRR, modified internal rate of return, which was an improvisation over the traditional IRR. And the last technique that we have covered under discounted cash flow techniques is the terminal value method. Okay. So these 8 techniques we have covered in the class with practical questions. Today, I'll give you a quick revision on the NPV technique. As I've told you, it is the most popular and most widely used technique of capital budgeting. Why is NPV so popular? NPV is basically present value of cash inflows minus the present value of cash outflows. So NPV is present value of cash inflows minus present value of all the cash outflows related to a project. Now, NPV will give you absolute addition to the wealth of the shareholder. So, in rupee terms, you get to know that due to this investment decision, how much money is being added to the wealth of the shareholder. So, as a result, we accept projects which have NPV greater than zero, and we reject projects which have a negative NPV as they are not leading to any addition in the wealth of the shareholder. They are actually decreasing the wealth of the shareholder. Okay, so under the NPV method and under all the discounted cash flow techniques, you have to consider the cash flows from a project decision, and these cash flows, as explained earlier, are divided into three categories. So we start with the initial cash outflow. Then you have the annual cash flows. These are the cash inflows from the project. And last is the terminal cash flow. That is the cash flow in the last year of the project. Okay. Any doubt, any problem till here? Anyone has a problem, you can unmute yourself and ask. So then we can move to the questions. Okay, so I'll move to the first question on NPV, which we will be practicing today. There on your screens, a machine purchased 6 years back for 1,50,000 has been depreciated to a value of 90,000. So this means that today the book value of the machine is rupees 90,000. Okay. So whenever you attempt questions, whenever you attempt these story questions on capital budgeting, always jot down the points that are given. So for old machine and then for the new machine. So we know today that for the old machine, the current book value is 90,000. Okay, after that, it had a projected life of 15 years, after which the scrap value would have been nil. A new machine will cost 2,50,000. There's a proposal to replace this machine. So the purchase price of the new machine is 2,50,000, and it will result in reduction of operating cost by 30,000 per annum for next 9 years. So you will replace the machine if A, it leads to an increase in your cash inflows, in your income, or B, it leads to a reduction in your operating cost. So your savings, if you purchase this machine, are 30,000 per annum. Okay. Now the new machine will be depreciated over the 9 year period with a salvage value of 25,000. So you are using the straight line method. Under the straight line method, every year the amount of depreciation remains the same, and the formula for straight line method is the initial investment in the machine minus scrap value divided by number of years of the life of the machine. So in this case, our investment horizon, our decision will be made over a period of 9 years. So your machine, which was of 2,50,000, will depreciate to 25,000, and the life of the machine is 9 years. So 2,25,000 divided by 9. How much does it make? 25,000 per annum. Not 25. What is the value, exact value coming to? 2,000. Okay, yes, it is 25,000 per annum. This is new machine. Now, apart from this, you are given that the existing machine can be replaced given the tax rate applicable is 30%, cost of capital is 10%. So, in this question, you are not required to calculate the capital gain, profit, or loss. So, let's start with the question. Step one is calculation of the initial cash outflow. Please start everyone with the question. First, calculate the initial cash outflow. Start attempting, then I'll help you with the question. Please start attempting. So in our case, we have the purchase price of the new machine as 2,50,000 and the scrap value of old machine as 50,000. So your initial cash outflow comes to 2,00,000 rupees. Now you can proceed with the second step. Yes, has anyone calculated the annual cash flows? Step 2. $28,500. Yes. What about others? Seems the others are not solving the question. Should I start asking you people to put your registers before the screen? So that way I think you will solve fast. So the depreciation on the old machine is 10,000 per annum, and on the new machine is 25,000 per annum, which makes the incremental depreciation as 15,000. This is the depreciation amount you will be considering. This is the second step. Manan, you solved. You getting a negative NPV. Let me check. Yes, correct. You are getting a negative NPV. Step 3 will be the terminal cash flow. So for the 9th year, cash flow will be 25,500 plus the scrap value of 25,000, which will give you 50,500. So now you are just required to put in these values in the NPV formula. Present value of cash inflows minus the present value of all cash outflows. So, NPV. So since the cash flows for 8 years are equal, you will use the PVAF table when calculating the present value of cash inflows for the first 8 years. And last year cash inflow is a single cash flow. So we use the PVF table 10% for the 9th year. Okay, and cash outflow is 2 lakh rupees because you also had the scrap value of the old machine. So this is 2 lakh. So now please complete the question, everyone. So I hope everyone is getting this answer. So you're facing a loss if you replace this machine. So it is better to reject the proposal to replace the machine. Okay, so let's move further.